Hi, and welcome back to 2 Minute Trumpet Tips. Today we're going to be talking about the two things. And just what are the two things? Well, there are two aspects of trumpet playing that a lot of people have problems with, and they seem to cure about 90% of all chop problems. Let's get started. No matter if you're a beginner or a seasoned professional, these two things probably result in about 90% of all chop problems, and they are very easy to fix. The first thing is you have to remember that the trumpet produces its sound because your lips are vibrating. All right? So this may sound like it's very obvious and it's kind of duh, but bottom line is, if you're hearing anything in your sound that is not the trumpet sound, an example would be what I call frizz-frazz or an air leak or any sort of weird sounds that aren't sound, aren't trumpet tone, about 90% of the time that's a result of your lips not being together when you're forming your embouchure. And just how do you get your lips into this position where they can vibrate effectively? Well, I tell students that you should start each note with your lips in a P or an M position. That's not white knuckling the chops. Make sure they're really tight together, but they just need to be touching so that when the air comes through, their only choice, their only option is to start vibrating. The second thing is even easier than that. And the second thing is energizing the airstream. And basically what I'm talking about here is you gotta take a full breath and get a little stretch on that upper chest and ribcage area in order to energize the entire airstream. If you just have a very passive release of the air, there's not enough energy there to really play the trumpet well, in my opinion. So you're probably saying to yourself, if you've listened to my other videos, I've heard you talk about this before. Well, that's because there's not that much to trumpet playing. It's just a piece of pipe that we're trying to make music with. So you're going to hear a lot of repeated themes here in my videos. But that's it. The two things. We'll be talking more about this in the wrap-up. Okay, so those are the two things. The first thing being, get your chops in a position where they have to vibrate, kind of idiot-proofing them, if you will. And the other thing is to energize the air in your lungs by taking a big, full breath, so it'll play the trumpet better. Now, as far as buzzing your chops, a lot of people will listen to this and think I'm trying to advocate just buzzing your chops and getting, you know, your chops to buzz and buzzing on a mouthpiece and buzzing without a mouthpiece and all that kind of stuff. Now, if that helps you, you should do that. And there's nothing necessarily wrong about it. The one thing that I do try and point out is that mouthpiece buzzing and lip buzzing by themselves are completely different than when you play the trumpet. The resistance is way, way different. And many times, the embouchure that you end up getting set up in order to facilitate a good free buzzing embouchure, that embouchure is going to be different than your trumpet playing embouchure. And if you have any doubts about that, get a visualizer and put it up there and look at your chops while you're playing in a mouthpiece and when you're not playing in a mouthpiece. A lot different. Personally, my thoughts are, again, if it helps you, you should do it. But I've never been paid to buzz a gig. So thus, most of my concentration when I'm practicing is with the trumpet. And if I want to do just some basic buzzing and not be thinking about the trumpet sound and bogged down with a lot of trumpet-specific stuff, I'll pull a tuning slide or just use a lead pipe. And I've got a video on that too someplace here on YouTube. Because when I use the lead pipe, the resistance and the blow is a lot more similar to actually playing the trumpet. As far as energizing your airstream, I do have a three-part series on air that's also part of this 2-Minute Trumpet Tips series, and you can check that on the links down here below. But it's also important to remember, whatever you're working on in the trumpet, even if it's something just as simple as taking a breath, keep in mind there are ways to do all of these things that actually make them more of a proactive thing than a passive aspect of your playing. And with your air, you really want to get the air in there in such a way that it wants to play the trumpet. That's not just sitting in your lungs, waiting for you to squeeze it out. And taking in a full breath and maybe 105% instead of just 100% breath in order to get that 5% little stretch on there, which is going to put a little bit of on the airstream. And that little bit of elastic recoil in that chest cavity area is what will give you the edge when it comes to being able to really play the trumpet well and have an energized airstream from the beginning to the end of a note. So idiot-proofing your practice. And, you know, we are talking about trumpet players here. Idiot-proofing your practice sometimes, I think, is really important. If you know how to practice to force things to work correctly and more efficiently, you're going to see a lot more and more steady improvement when you practice. So, remember, get your lips into a P or an M position when you're about to start the notes. That doesn't mean you attack the notes using the P or M syllable, but put them in that closed lip position and then blow the air into the back of the lips and let them start vibrating. And you're going to blow energized air into those lips so that you get a very solid and steady vibration. That's about it on the two things. A lot of what I went over here in the two things video came from an article I wrote about a year ago called The Two Things. And I'll put a link down here to that article. I've got it on Facebook and a couple other places. I'll put a link down there where you can read the article. It's got a little bit of the same information, a little different information in there. But now that you've managed to get to this point in this video, I think it'll make even more sense. So check that out. And if you like the video, hit subscribe. Give me a thumbs up, wherever they are down there. And leave a comment if you've got questions, answers, whatever. Leave a comment. I love hearing what you've got to say. And you know what to do. Go practice.